gonna break this tutorial down into three parts. We're gonna look at getting the rotation of the 180, we're gonna look at the rollout, and then how to improve your 180s. Before you start 180s, your bunny hops have to be really good. You've got to be picking up your front wheel before your back wheel. If you're picking up both wheels at the same time, it's going to be impossible to do a 180. Once your bunny hops are really good, you can start trying to do a 90. Once you've got these, you can move on to trying slow 180s. Okay, so now let's break the 90 down into each step. So you notice that the body's already compressed, ready to jump up, and the bars are already turning a bit to the left. So this stage looks a lot like a regular bunny hop, except the head's already turning into the left, left shoulder's dropped a little bit, and the bars are turned. So at this point, you jump off the back wheel, and with the spin that's already been generated, you can see the whole bike is already starting to turn. Okay, the first difference you'll notice between the 180 and the 90 is that when you compress down, you compress a lot more. Here you can also see how much harder my head is turning into the left, and also you can notice how much pressure there is on the back wheel. Notice how my head is turning a lot faster, and this clip is great because it shows just how much your shoulder leans into the side you're turning to and how much your head turns. And you can already see the arms which are starting to pull the front end round as the back end is jumping up to get the back end round. Notice here how my head is already in the position it should be for when I land, and the rest of the body is coming around. Here my body is starting to line up with the bike, and I'm leaning backwards as I land to prepare for the rollout, which we'll look at later. So if we look at this from the front view, we can notice a couple of other things. So you'll notice just how much the body is leaning out, and this is what gives you your leverage to kick the back end round. If your body is over the top tube, you're not going to be able to give your legs any power to kick your back wheel around. So notice how when my back wheel leaves the ground, my legs are straight, and look at how my shoulder is dipping into the turn, and my head as well. It's good to have your legs straight at this stage, because then you can pull your back end up if you're 180ing over something, or yeah. So here I land back wheel first quite a lot. I like to do this because it absorbs a bit of the shock. So notice how my body is still over the bike, so I don't lose any balance, and I'm ready to roll out backwards. This clip shows even better just how far out your body has to be when you start your 180s. This is probably the most important bit, as having your body out like this means that when you pull your legs up, you're also pulling your back wheel towards the direction of the spin. So you're not really kicking the back end out, you're sort of pulling it with your body, with your legs. Notice how I'm pulling the bars up almost to my knees. So now let's look at all those clips again in slow motion. It's important to practice 180s slowly first for two reasons. Firstly, you're not going to injure yourself as much if you're doing them slowly. And secondly, going slowly means that you can't use your front wheel to spin as much and therefore, which is the right way to do it. Now at full speed. Now let's look at the rollout. So as you approach the wall, sort of jump up as your front tire touches it and push forward with your bars and pick your back end up by bending your legs. Definitely the best tip for rolling backwards is to lean a lot over the back wheel like you would during a manual. The reason this helps a lot is because your back wheel doesn't move, it's stable. Whereas if you lean too much over the front, you might shoot out. So once you can fakie quite well, you can start trying to learn how to actually roll out. So the roll out is just going from fakie to rolling back forwards normally. So this is done by turning your bars at one point, starting to turn your body, and if you have brakes, you can pull your brake to help spin the front end round, and if you don't have brakes, you can apply a bit of pressure on your cranks to help spin the front end round. Once you started to figure these out by pushing off a wall, you can start trying to fakie from a 180. So if you're having trouble rolling out or faking after a 180, you can try this. You just bunny hop normally, and as you land, straight away you crank back once, and this will just get you used to cranking backwards as you land. So here I was actually riding brakeless because my brakes were broken. So if you're riding brakeless, you don't actually have to use any crank pressure. You can just sort of pull up on your handlebars to bring the front end round. That's about it for the rollout. Let's look at how you can improve your 180s. The first thing you can do is you can start doing them faster. This is important because if you're going to start 180ing down things and up things, you're going to need quite a bit of speed. So I would start trying to 180 over lines on the ground. Here I'm 180ing over a broom. This is good because it's flat and it doesn't really matter if my front wheel lands on it. First, start trying 180s up curves. I would definitely ride parallel to the curb and sort of jump up onto it, going to the side. Because if you're gonna try and go perpendicular to it the first couple of times, you might hit your front wheel on the curb and you get a flat, and that's not good. Really, the only difference when you're jumping up a curb is you've just got to compress more and pull up. You don't really have to spin that much more. Okay, so the last thing you can do to improve your 180s is you can start doing them off of obstacles. The best thing to start with would be a curb, and once you've got that, you can build your confidence up and start doing it off the big objects. You want to go as slow as possible at first to not injure yourself, and the most important thing is to commit to it. And if you commit and stay on the pedals, not much can go wrong. It's if you take your feet off and hope for the best that's when you're going to hurt yourself. The 180 does take a long time to learn. It is a pretty frustrating trick, but once you've got it figured out, you can definitely use it in a lot of situations, and it looks pretty good. So that's about it for the 180. If you have any questions or comments, just let me know in the boxes below, and if you like this video, then subscribe and rate it.